Right, so I've started recording. I was live streaming. It cut off about 2 minutes into the live stream. How fucking annoying. That's the second time in a week it's done that with me. Well pissed off. Anyway, so I'm just going to record it and then I'll upload it and maybe do a premiere or something, right? So what I was saying, and I'm just repeating myself here, talking about jealous women, right? So it's still recording. Good, right, okay. Fucking hell. What a fucking pain in the ass. This shit, YouTube needs to sort that shit. That's not my end, by the way. That's not my internet. That's fucking YouTube's end. So I'm talking about jealous women, right? Now, what I was talking about before I get cut off, for those who didn't see it, was I was talking about Carl Pilkington, who made a show called, The Moaning of Life, right? Carl Pilkington is bald, right? And I was talking about how he got this wig put on, stuck onto his head, and he was full of confidence, he was happy, he felt youthful, you know. And then he sent a photo of it to his girlfriend, and she texted back, oh, you look stupid, you look like an idiot, right? And he was crushed, absolutely crushed. He was happy. A guy that's never happy. He was happy, and then she fucking destroyed it just by saying he looked like an idiot, which, by the way, he didn't. The clip will probably be on YouTube somewhere. I know that it's somewhere, because I remember commenting on it once. But anyway, that was years ago. The Moaning of Life, Carl gets a wig or something. Look that up, and you might find it. So her jealousy completely ruined his happiness. I mean, just... We've never seen a photo of her. He's mentioned a few times that she's fat, right? So I'm guessing she was worried that he's got his confidence back, he's looking good, he might leave her. So she wanted to ruin all that, you know, and just tell him that he looks like an idiot, which he didn't, and, you know, totally ruin his fucking day. Total cow for doing that, by the way. That's where someone told me in the comments, that's where the video cut off, just as I got to that bit. So you probably didn't hear me say, when I was reading this article, which I'm about to read, I read the start of it, I didn't read it all. When I read the start of this article, I thought, boom, there's another reason why men wouldn't want to be in a relationship with a woman. So what I want you to do, right, without trying to be funny or anything like that, I want you to write down a list of reasons why men would want to be in a relationship with women, right? Well, why would they want to be in a relationship with a woman, as in go out with them, live with them, you know? Don't have to marry, but why would they want to have them in their life, taking up space in their life, right? Because I believe the reasons to not have them in your life far outweigh the reasons to have them in your life, you know? And I think they know that as well, which is why they get so annoyed at the idea of sex robots and stuff, because they can't even compete with a fucking robot, you know. I think women are putting on a really poor show, you know, when it comes to that. You know, they should be making themselves, making men want to be with them, but they seem to be doing the complete opposite. But anyway, so let's go into this article, right, about jealous women, right? Fucking unreal. This is in The Sun. Link in the description. Jealous women confess, I was so jealous I called the police and told them my boyfriend was a sex abuser when I saw him talking to a younger woman. Just a normal thing to do. A raging plane passenger hit the headlines this summer after she was filmed lamping her boyfriend with a laptop because he looked at another woman. While many were shocked at her violent and inappropriate behaviour, and no one would condone it, for some women and men, the pictures of her jealous rage struck a chord. Now, here's the thing that I was shocked at, right? I remember this. By the way, that wasn't the only one. There was two round about the same period of women attacking their boyfriends on a plane, right? And in two of those cases, the headlines read something along the lines of couple fight on plane, you know, even though it was clearly her fighting on a plane and not the man. Because if it was the other way around and he was lamping her with a laptop, the headline would have been, you know, evil man beats women with laptop. It wouldn't have been both of them had a fight. But that's how it was reported. It was reported as if both of them had a fight and then both of them had to get removed from the plane, you know. The guy would probably have left the plane anyway if his girlfriend got kicked off, but still, don't see why he has to get kicked off the plane when he's the one getting hit with a laptop. Would the woman have to leave the plane if she was getting hit with a laptop? I don't think so. But that's what I found shocking, not really, about the story. Here, three women confess the extreme and sometimes illegal lengths they've gone to when their green-eyed monster has been roused. I hack his WhatsApp and puncture his tires. I mean, just avoid, man. Full-time mum... God, fucking... Full-time... Mum. You mean mum? She's not full-time... Why? That's not a job, is it? Mum. Full-time mum. Full-time mum? What company do you work for? Oh, you don't work for a company? Alright, so are you a self-employed mum? What? How's that work? Full-time mum? Fuck off, man. Olivia Taylor, 22, lives with her partner and their two children in West London. Look at him there. Look, that's her partner. The face of happiness. The face of pure joy. Because he's stuck with that thing there, man. Fucking, look how happy he looks. Oh, man. Me and my other half have been together in a very on and off relationship over the last 6 years. Guilty as charged, I do get jealous. If he doesn't come straight home from work, I'm wondering where he is. I don't trust him, and I do have a massive jealous streak. That's why I found a way in to get my partner's WhatsApp conversations from my phone so I can see who he is talking to and when I'm not with him. He probably thinks I'm some sort of psychic when I start quizzing him about some of his conversations. No, psycho. He is macho and likes to go for a sauna and a spa. Did you just say macho and then follow up with sauna and a spa? What? No, he is macho and likes to eat razor blades and drink lava. That's macho. Going for a fucking sauna and a spa? That's not macho. This is gay as you can get. Macho. He is macho and likes to go for a sauna and spa after work with his friends. Does he now? No wonder you're jealous. I don't think you're jealous for other women, though. I think there's something going on there. He's so macho, he's going for a sauna and a spa with his friends. Come on, something's going on there. It means I get left at home with the kids. Wait a minute, what do you mean you get left at home with the kids? Don't you mean you get left at work? You're at work, remember, because that's your job, isn't it? Remember, you're a full-time mum, that's your job, remember. You're not at home, you're at work. Isn't that how it works? If I have a weird vibe about what's going on then, in the past, I punctured the tyre on his bike. Fucking hell. No bike, no trip to the sauna. I know perfectly well there is no way he can repair a puncture in an evening. So, this is a thing with women, right? So if I get a weird vibe, right? So she gets a weird vibe, and this weird vibe, this thing, this something tells her that he's cheating on her. This weird vibe she gets is that he's cheating on her, right? Isn't it funny about these women, the weird vibe or the something, it never tells them that he needs his dick sucked. Do you ever notice that? It's funny that, isn't it? It's funny how the weird vibe doesn't say, by the way, you need to suck his dick. That's funny, that, isn't it? It's always like a bad thing that he's doing. It's weird how that works. Something tells me something's going on, but something never tells me to suck his cock. Funny how that works. Just avoid, man. She once hid her boyfriend's passport for a week so he couldn't book a holiday with pals. I mean, this is just a pure cunt. And see, the thing is, by the way, see all of this that she's doing? The slashed tires and the WhatsApp, breaking into his WhatsApp and all. That's domestic violence. If a man does it, if a man does that, that is absolute domestic violence. I mean, literally according to the law. Unreal, man. Because that's controlling behaviour. Controlling coercive behaviour. She's a fucking abuser, man, according to the law. She says there was no way he was going to a European sex capital without me. I wouldn't worry anyway. He sounds like he's into men, if you're asking, you know what I mean? I hid his passport before lad's holiday. Then there was a time I hid his passport for a week, so he couldn't book a holiday with his friends. He was supposed to go to Amsterdam with the boys. It was probably a stag do or something. There was no way he was going to a European sex capital without me. Four blokes on a weekend away in Amsterdam? I don't think so. Okay, because of the stereotype, you probably think he's going to go to the red light district and all that. Right, okay. But, I mean, if you were cool, you'd probably let it happen, you know? But you're not cool. So you take control and make sure he can't go because you're an abuser. You're a domestic abuser. He did interrogate me about it, and to this day, he was never sure if I was lying or not. I told him he was looking too hard for it, and it would turn up in an obvious place. It did within hours of the plane departing. Did I feel guilty? Nope. And that's because you're a woman. Women don't have that ability to feel guilty about anything. Then there was the time I was staying at my mum's. I panicked and got it into my head he'd be inviting random people, including women, over to ours. You see what I mean? She never gets it into her head to suck his dick. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? It's weird how that works. It's really bizarre that. I mean, doesn't she ever question that? Hey, how come the things that keep coming into my head are always bad? How come it's never, you know, give my back rub or something? How's it, I mean, fucking hell. I couldn't handle my jealousy that day, and no matter how I tried to rationalise it to myself, I was still jealous. So I hid his house keys, or as I like to say, he lost them. He had to stay at his mum's house that night too. I'm betting I'm not the only woman who lives like this either. No, you're not. And I hope men are watching this video. I hope all men either watch this video or read this article. Avoid, avoid, avoid. Use them for one thing and that's it. Really? At this point, I probably wouldn't have said this 10 years ago. But at this point, the internet really has exposed women to men. And I think men are kind of stupid now if they let women move in with them. At this point, you know, they've been exposed. The internet has exposed them. I check for hairs and sniff the bed sheets. Here's another woman to fuck it. Care assistant Maggie Ralph Jones, 43, is single and has 3 kids. Oh, sign me up. She lives in Sheffield. She has previously counted condoms and checked bed sheets for hairs that aren't hers. Fucking CSI, man. Jesus. I'm currently single, and while life is easier, I'd love to find a bloke who is faithful. I'm a possessive girlfriend. Don't oversell yourself. Come on now. I'm sure they're lining up. In the past, I've routinely counted out the condoms in the packet by the bed. I look in the bins. I've checked bed sheets for hairs that aren't mine. I'll sniff the pillows and bed sheets too. What a fucking freak, man. One time I found a used sanitary towel in the bathroom bin. I bet it was hers. I was fuming. When the bloke I was seeing arrived home that night, I emptied it out over his car that and demanded he explain who it belonged to. Turned out it was his mum's, apparently. Jesus. One ex received a thong in the post. He swore blind he wasn't cheating. We'd rented a house together and were even trying for a baby. I saw red when that G-string fell out of the envelope. In a fury, I took a pair of scissors and snipped one arm off every single one of his shirts. Pure psychopath. I let down the tyres on his car and he had to use my VW Beetle, covered in flowers, to go into his job as a security officer the next day. Right. All of these things here she's doing, especially the cutting up his, letting down his tyres and cutting off one arm off every one of his shirts. I mean, that is Fatal Attraction stuff. That is Bunny Boiler stuff. It is, it's the kind of thing a man would get a prison sentence for that. That's guaranteed, by the way. A man would get a prison sentence for that if the woman went to the police and cried, fake tears, and said that she was scared. He'd go to prison for that. He sprained his ankle. That taught him a lesson. Then there was the time we were going on holiday together. We were camping and a group of girls were in the tent next to us. They invited us round for a drink. The usual flirting started. I pretended to go to the loo and instead I pulled up one of the tent pegs so it was higher than it was supposed to be. I sent him to get me some headache tablets because I wasn't feeling very well. I told him I'd lost the torch. In the dark, he tripped over the tent peg. Cut his knee, bruised his shin, and sprained his ankle. That put paid to any more nonsense between him and girls young enough to be his daughters. The fuck, man. I called the police after spotting him with younger women. Another time, we went away for the weekend. I did some shopping, and when I got back, I found him swimming in the lake, throwing a frisbee with a teenager who looked like something on the page of Sports Illustrated. In a fit of jealousy, I called the police and told them I was worried about a man with an underage girl. I mean, she could have gotten fucking put in prison, man. They arrived within minutes. Of course they did. Blue lights flashing, and questioned both of them. Turns out she was 21 and on holiday with her girlfriend. To this day, he doesn't know it was me who did that. Oh my God, what a cunt. In the end, I gave him the boot for my own peace of mind. For his fucking, to his benefit. I might have been a bit OTT jealous. Oh, really? Just a bit? But he gave me loads of reasons to be, to behave like that. Two words, look, behave. To behave like that. Men are like dogs and will stray if they can. And women are like psychotic cows who will cut your shirts up and ensure injuries and call the police on you. If they can. Fucking sexist bitch. Here's another one. I get so frustrated I change his phone passwords. Mum Annie Graham. Wait a minute. Mum? Is that a full-time mum or is it a part-time mum? What kind of mum is this? I don't know. Are you a self-employed mum? You know, are you a mum who's currently out of work? What kind of mum are you? Fucking... The first one was a full-time mum. How come this one's just mum? Annie Graham, 23, lives with her partner and their son in South London. Minger, right, next. Annie says she gets so frustrated she sometimes changes her partner's phone passwords. I don't get jealous about everyday stuff. If we're out together, he won't so much as look at another female cleavage or bum. Aye, to your knowledge. By the way, there's a trick for that. This is a trick I used to do, right? It's fucking brilliant, right? This is brilliant, right? And it fucking works like a charm, right? See if there's a good-looking woman and you're with your girlfriend, right? And you want to look at that woman, right? And get away with it. I have got a solution. I really have, right? What you do is you turn to your girlfriend and you say, you would suit that, and just name anything she's wearing, whether it's a hairstyle, a blouse, a skirt, whatever, and say, you know, you would suit that. And then she looks at the woman, and you look at the woman, and she, because the woman's bound to be pretty, you're not going to look at an ugly woman, she takes it as a compliment, she's chuffed, you get to look at the woman, and you get away with it. It works like a fucking charm, by the way. So if you're ever out with your girlfriend or wife and you want to look at another woman, just do that. I guarantee it's perfect, and they never know. They never know. If he gets a private message on Snapchat from a woman... Oh, wait a minute. Oh, no, sorry. I'm away down here. Look, I'm supposed to be up here. Sorry. Let me start again. My problem is mainly about the time my other half spends on social media and the number of women he is in touch with. He tells me it's platonic, and while I want to believe him, there is a jealous streak in me that wants to punish him. There is that little voice in my head saying on repeat, why am I not enough? Again, the little voice in her head never says, why don't you suck him off? Never says that. Why don't you bounce on his bones? It would cheer him up. It never says that. Why don't you let him watch the football in peace? It never says that. Why don't you go to your mother's without asking him to go with you? The little voice never says that. No. It's always bad stuff. It's always bad stuff. It drives me mad how many women follow him online. They contact him in the evenings and at weekends too. Well, say to the women then. What normal woman wouldn't be jealous if the father of her child was chatting back and forth day and night on Instagram or Snapchat? I can understand why you don't like that. I totally get that. I have rules in place. I now have rules in place. If it's the evening and we are watching a TV program, then that's our couple time. So you're taking control. That's controlling behaviour. That's domestic violence. If he gets a private message on Snapchat from a woman and chooses to read it, then I switch the TV off, unplug it and tell him, talk to her or watch the telly with me. You really should never give a man an ultimatum. You know, you shouldn't do it. It's stupid. I get so frustrated sometimes that I change the passwords on his phone. By blocking it, he can't use it. It winds him up, but it stops me from being so jealous, so job done. Selfish cow, man. There was one week when one female friend contacted him over 100 times. I was that annoyed and jealous that I forgot to wash his football kit. We started rowing, and then I put it on the tumble dryer on a 2-hour cycle. A tumble dryer won't turn off, so he had to stand there watching his kit be tossed around and miss out on football practice. I've also hidden his footy boots too. What a cunt, man. I mean, oh my God. She checks his social media accounts all the time. I rule his phone. Controlling behaviour. I do check his accounts all the time. I know the passwords, and if I see he has liked another girl's pictures, I will bombard him at work with calls demanding to know who she is. Fucking hell, man. I rule his phone. I'll put it on silent so he doesn't hear it ring or the ping of the messages. If there's a number of a random girl on his phone, I'll block her too. Sometimes I think it might be easier to put a tracker on his phone. He hasn't ever done anything to make me this distrustful of him, but he knows I get jealous, so why does he do it? Oh, it's his fault. See, that's the same with my imaginary wife. You know, she knows I'm going to slap her, so why does she stand there and get in the way of my hand? I mean, she knows I'm going to slap her. And yet she stands there, you know, when she knows my hand is near her face. I mean, it's unbelievable. It's her fault. It's her fault she's getting slapped, not mine. Not mine. No, I don't have an agency, you crazy. If he annoys me in this way, then I am going to do the same to him. Fucking unreal, man. There's comments on this, apparently. Oh, see this. Look at this shit. What the fuck is going on here? What the fuck is this? There we go. Show more comments. Oh, there we go. If a man was that controlling, they'd be locked up. That's exactly what I said. Exactly what I said. They would be locked up, especially if she cried. This is sick, the behaviour and the way this is presented. If this was a bunch of abusive and violent men proudly boasting about the way they control, harm, threaten and hurt their partners, this would be part of a domestic violence campaign, definitely. There would be outrage and feminist mouthpieces popping up in the news, but because the victims are men and the abusers are women, you think this content is fine, don't you? Sexist, appallingly sexist. I mean, they didn't report on it like it was funny, but they also didn't condemn it the way they would have done if it was men that were doing it. We live in a gynocentric and misandristic society where abusing men is seen as perfectly acceptable. What they're doing is domestic abuse. Absolutely. According to their rules that they created, it is definitely domestic abuse. But they're women, so they're allowed to abuse men, apparently. Clearly, if it's done to men, then it's funny, apparently. Typical double standards. Again, to be fair to this article, it didn't come across like they were saying it was funny. But it didn't condemn it either, the way they would have if it was men. And there was none of the adjectives in place that would have been there for men, you know. Abusive, you know, evil, nasty, horrible, bully, you know, none of those words were there, you know. Those women should be arrested, but we live in a female supremacist society where the Duluth model ensures that innocent and even abused men are automatically seen as abusive and arrested, but women are all sugar and spice and all things nice and allowed to commit crimes and destroy lives with impunity. I can just imagine outcry if this were men in this article instead of women. Exactly, man. John, you're 100% right. If I may add, my husband would have walked had I shown any signs of such dreadful, unjustified behaviour. But the thing is, a lot of this behaviour they said the husband didn't know about. Like the guy, or the boyfriend. The boyfriend didn't know that it was his girlfriend that phoned the police on him. You know? The other boyfriend didn't know that it was his girlfriend that was hiding his keys. You know? Things like that. I have never been violent to a man. But, you know, that reminds me of that Chris Rock joke. You know, when the black guy says, "I ain't never been to jail." And it's like, well, you're not supposed to go to fucking jail, are you? You're not supposed to be violent to a man. You're not getting a cookie for that, are you? Fuck's sake. I've never been violent to a man. Well done. Fucking well. Thanks for telling us that. I took that as read, but now that you've said it, I'm a bit suspicious. So these cunts on fucking Twitter who put in their bio, I'm against racism. Well, I thought that anyway. Why do you have to say that? That makes me suspicious. That makes me think you're totally a racist. I have a little confession to make. I once checked on a partner's pants once after he went on a stag do night. I checked on them the next day to see if I could find any evidence of activity. All I could find was a skid mark. Aye, but was it his skid mark? See, now you're thinking, right? Now you're thinking. Unreal. Although that's what she deserves. I would say that it is 100% emotional abuse, domestic violence, but they're women, so it's okay. It absolutely is. Again, not according to me, but according to their rules, it is. That is not normal. I mean, it's definitely controlling behaviour. you know, and it shouldn't be acceptable. But I don't think they should go to prison for it. They should just get, let's just get a dry slap, actually. That's all they should get for it. It's a fucking dry slap. Don't fucking do that again, you know. But you can't do that, you know. It makes you the bad guy, apparently. That is not normal. There you go, men. Look and remember their faces. Now, don't look and remember their faces. Just remember, this is women. This is women. Prove me wrong. These people need to be in a nut house. How can you treat somebody you love like this? Either trust them or boot them. I can understand why their blokes might cheat, as they're all ugly, deranged nutters. I'm embarrassed for them. I can't believe these people not only admitted to this, but agreed to have their full names and pictures here. If I were any one of the boyfriends or exes, I'd run. They're all soon to be killers and bunny boilers. Narcissism is an awful mental problem. If men done this, we would be locked up, and rightly so. Equality is great if it helps your cause, right? Wow, just wow. These women need help and their partner should move on. Not being funny, but these women should be arrested, especially the second one for wasting police time on a bogus call-out. Aye, that one, aye, she should be arrested. She should be arrested for falsely accusing a man like that. This is why domestic violence happens. That's a good point. You know, because how could you not be tempted to slap somebody who treated you like that? You know? How could you not? Let's be honest, right? Let's look at it in a different way. Now, let's say you're on holiday, and a couple of women, because they're adult women, they go, oh, I throw a frisbee at you, and you throw it back, you know. And a guy you know, phones the police on you. What are you going to do to that guy? You've got to give him more than a fucking slap. So surely you can understand why you'd want to slap a woman who did it. So aye, this is why domestic violence happens. One of the reasons. Nothing more than a bunch of bunny boilers. Why do these women bother? No trust at all. Sound like more of an episode of Fatal Attraction linked to Bunny Boiler. If roles were reversed, we were reading about abusive controlling men, then there would be outrage. Why is it okay for women to be abusive towards a man? Because he deserved it. Why is it okay for soaps to casually show scenes in which a woman slaps a man around the face? Why is it okay that some women agree with this abuse, but as soon as a man does something deemed controlling, these women call the police? It's the kind of shit you get on fucking The View. You know what I mean? Where if they showed a woman doing this, they'd all be laughing. Oh, hilarious. Oh, my God, it's hilarious. Or that other fucking talk show with a black woman, The Real. Oh, my God. I need to watch more of that just to make videos about it. What a joke that show is. The Real. Fucking The Real. what will we call this? We'll call it a bunch of fucking hens clocking away. No, we won't call it that. We need to call it something that sounds black and street. How about The Real? Brilliant. Fucking The Real, what a joke. But on that, they'd be like, oh, fucking, quite right, girl, you go, girlfriend, you know, and all that other black talk. And they'd be saying how great it was that you changed his password. You can't trust these dogs. You can't trust these niggers and all that shit they'd be saying. But then if it was a man doing it, they'd be like, oh my God, he should be put in prison. It's disgusting. Cut his dick off. You know, and then the audience would all applaud. Woo! Fucking idiots. This is absolutely disgusting. Why would you even post this? These women should be reported for abuse. If this was men saying they do this to women, it would be a different story. Disgusting behaviour. These women need help. By the way, there's a few women saying these things according to the names. Psychopaths, some of whom should have been prosecuted for their actions. Yep. Jeez, these women are one step away from psychopath. One step away. I think they're already there. I mean, you think about it. Totally unhinged and controlling. If a woman was treated this way, everybody would be talking about red flags and telling them to run for the hills. I am ashamed to be of the same gender. Say again, another woman. And lots of people pointing out the double standard, which is good, because there is a clear double standard. Anyway, I've linked to the article if you want to read more of those comments. I would apologise for the live stream cutting off. It wasn't my fault. My internet's fine. I've checked the speed. It's perfectly fine. Nothing wrong with my internet. It's fucking YouTube. Fucking about. Anyway. As I say, I might premiere this. Join in the chat. Thank you very much for listening. Until next time. I don't need to do a countdown on this one, because I'm not live streaming. So I can just stop recording. Now.